Rodgers admitted during a podcast interview that he was not elated when the Packers drafted quarterback Jordan Love with the 26th pick. When asked about what he thought Green Bay's plans were at the position, he said, quote, just look at the facts. They traded up. They drafted him. I would say they like him. They want to play him. So, Shannon, let's read between the lines here. What is he actually saying?
Jimmy, I don't need to read between the lines. Aaron Rodgers says, my time is numbered here. He understands that, Skip. He's like, look at what I've done. I went to the NFC Championship game, Skip. I was 13-3. I'm still playing at an elite level, and you take a quarterback. Not only did you take a quarterback in the first round, you traded up to make sure you were able to get him in the first round. So Aaron Rodgers is basically saying, Skip, I know that if I want to play into my 40s, it's going to be elsewhere. And Skip, since 2000, this is the third time that has happened, that a team have drafted a quarterback after they go to the championship game. That happened with the Broncos. They took Paxton Lynch, but Peyton Manning retired. It happened with the Broncos in 05. Jake Plummer took them to the AFC championship game. They drafted your guy, Jay Cutler. And here we did it again. I don't know what it is about Denver. Denver did this in 91. We went to the championship game and they drafted Tommy Maddox the next year. So I don't know what it is with Denver with quarterbacks going to the championship game, Skip, and feeling they need a quarterback.
I don't know. Something's in that water. Maybe it's the atmosphere, right?
But the thing was, but Aaron Rodgers is he understands. And this notion, Aaron was, Skip, remember they tried to paint it? Aaron was fine with it. You know, he even reached out to Jordan Love and congratulated him. I said, bull jive. The Aaron Rodgers, you know, Skip, is as competitive as all get out. He's supremely confident. And basically they say, man, we don't believe you can do this much longer, and we're going to usher you right on up out the door. But he should, Skip, I mean, once you saw this happen with Joe Montana and all these other quarterbacks, with Peyton and Tom Brady, the writing's on the wall. Nobody's safe. If they get rid of Tom Brady, nobody's ever going to be safe again, Skip. And so Aaron Rodgers realized that for me to play as long as I want to play, I'm probably going to have to – I'm going to take my show on the road. I'm going to finish my career elsewhere. Now, remember, Brett Favre won the division the year they drafted Aaron Rodgers. They were 10-6. They won the division, and they took Aaron Rodgers. Now, Aaron Rodgers was a top – a lot of people thought he was going to go number one overall. He slid, and Ted Thompson said, we'd be a fool not to take him here at this spot.
24?
Green Bay's like, just to make sure nobody else takes this guy, we're going to move up to get him. So that was no read between the lines. It was a big old billboard. Aaron Rodgers, we're taking a quarterback, and we want you to move on within the very near future.
Yet you still say Aaron Rodgers has lost nothing.
He ain't lost a thing.
I have always compared Aaron Rodgers to LeBron James. I've said that Aaron is the LeBron of the National Football League. What is LeBron known for? His management style, so to speak, is passive-aggressive messages via social media or interviews, right?
Yeah.
This was a classic LeBron memorial passive-aggressive call-out of his management and his coach. That's to me, because he said what he said on this Spotify podcast. With a matter-of-fact sort of shrug, right? It wasn't vitriolic. Yeah. It wasn't over-emotional.
Skip, he resigned to the fact the man knows his fate.
It sounded like resignation.
Yes!
But the resignation serves two purposes. Because, number one, it turns up the heat on the GM and the coach. As if to say, well, I guess that's what you want. That's what you're going to get, right? And it also turns up the sympathy among the many Aaron Rodgers fans still left out there, because they're going to say, look what they're doing to our guy.
Poor Aaron.
Poor Aaron. They're pushing him right out the back door. How dare they do this to our guy, Aaron Rodgers? Well, I'm fine with that. By the way, just a quick aside, I'm starting to worry about Aaron a little bit, because did you see the quotes about, he said, as much as he loves scotch, now he's taken to drinking what he calls sipping tequila.
Yeah.
Did you see this?
Yeah.
And so the night of the draft, he said he got a text that they'd traded up to take Jordan Love. So I guess he wasn't actually watching the draft like a lot of people would. So he gets the text and he thinks, well, it's going to be a long night.
Right.
So he said, I had to go to the pantry to pull out some sipping tequila, and I poured myself four fingers, he said, of the sipping tequila, because it was going to be a long night of a lot of people bombarding him with poor Aaron text, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, you don't need to say
I'm starting to worry about it.
Nah, just go ahead and get your thing and just go and take it to the head.
Really?
And the next thing you know, it's the morning.
Really?
You close like, how my clothes get up on the
fan? That's kind of what he did that night.
You looking around like, how my clothes get on the fan?
Yeah.
And who took my shoes off?
Well, and he was seeing the handwriting on the wall of his Malibu mansion, right?
Yeah.
I mean, it's not your Bel Air mansion, but it's Malibu beachfront.
And you know, him and Danica split.
There they split.
So this might have had an adverse effect. Do the Packers realize what they've done, Skip? This might have had an impact on him and his personal life.
Mm.
I don't think the Packers realize what they've done. You go from drinking Doers or Johnny Walker to drinking Jose Cuervo.
Mm.
Man, come on, Skip.
Mm. So they did that to him.
They did that. I don't like this. I don't like it. Look, the Packers really helped me. You know, my brother played 7 years with the Packers,
yep.
But I don't like this.
So you're kind of like Tad Prescott, the brother.
Yeah,
the brother.
Yeah.
You're saying I don't even know how I can root for the Packers next year.
Yeah,
right?
I don't even know if I still got love in my heart for the Packers after doing this because it's tough on the man.
Okay. Here's my takeaway and my two cents from a distance. What I wanted to hear Aaron Rodgers say is enough of this. If he's still the guy you say he is, if he's still the guy that the evaluators and personnel men and coaches and coordinators told the Athletic and voted him into the top tier, they voted him the third best quarterback. The players last night voted him the 16th best player. So he fell out of the top 10. He fell behind Tom Brady, who was 14th. Mm-hmm. First time Tom didn't make the top 10 since this poll was brought into
10 years.
Existence. Yep. But the point is, I would love to hear Aaron say, I'm still that guy, and I'm about to show you I'm still that guy, because nobody can stop him from playing at a high level.
Yeah, that's what you wanted to hear?
Yep.
Jenny, you know what? There was a time, I think it was 2017, that a quarterback, that the head coach wanted to replace the quarterback, and that guy didn't say, I'm still that guy. That was my turn. He took his butt upstairs to his dad, Mr. Kraft, and said, tell him don't do this.
Mm.
And Mr. Kraft told Coach Belichick, you will trade Jimmy G. So I wanted your guy to say, I'm still that guy.
Mm.
Instead of running his little puny tail upstairs and crying.
Mm. My guy ran his little puny self right out onto the field for the fourth quarter against Jacksonville in the AFC Championship game. Following the 2017 season, and he threw for 138 in the fourth quarter to bring them back from 20-10 down.
Did he do that? Did he say, I'm still that guy, or did he go upstairs and tell Mr. Coach Mr. Kraft to have Coach Belichick not to do this and to get rid of Jimmy G? Did he do that? Because Seth Wickersham wrote an unbelievable article, and then Tom Brady, Mr. Kraft, and Coach Belichick release some old
bull. Tom Brady said, I am still that guy, and I'm about to show you.
No, that's not what he said.
I'm about to show you.
That's not what he did, Skip.
And when he got to the Super Bowl, he threw for an all-time playoff record, 505. No one's ever done that. He backed it up. Then he went and won another Super Bowl and another Super Bowl. He just kept showing you, I'm going to do this.
That's not what the article reported happened. Now, you know that. You know he went upstairs and would cry.
Aaron Rodgers hasn't even been to a Super Bowl for 10 years. It's time for him to take ownership of this and say, if you'll let me start game one, you're not going to be able to get this job away from me. And you're going to have to forget about it.
What do you mean, let me start?
Well, that's what, is he going to be the starter for game one, or is Jordan Love? I'm pretty sure he will. So if he's the starter for game one, he should be the starter for game number 16 and all the way through the playoffs, and he should show you he's the third best quarterback in the league.
Skip, I don't care if it's Jordan Love, Buddy Love, Bryce Love.
Okay.
I don't care. Aaron Rodgers is the guy in Green Bay.
Okay, so why didn't he just say that? Why does he do, oh, whoa, am I?
Hold up. Your guy was upstairs, went upstairs
he
crying.
Didn't say a word about
he
it.
He cried.
How do you know?
He cried.
Nobody reported
he
cried.
He pulled a Draymond Green.
No.
Draymond was in the parking lot with a towel. He was in the man's office.
You know
that
what?
Was only the second time he had been in Mr. Kraft's office.
He pulled a boss move. He showed you who was boss.
That's a boss move.
He walked right upstairs to the owner and he said, no, I run this. I'm going to show you. And then he went and backed it up and kept backing it up for three more years.
Well, the Packers don't have ownership. They have shareholders. So Aaron couldn't go to the owner.
Yeah.
How about
I think
that?
Aaron's just sort of giving up.
Download the all-new Fox Sports app now.